Hey guys, it's Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus, and welcome to a UV mapping tutorial. In this video, we are going to be covering how to UV map an axe and get it ready for texturing. If you're interested in downloading this axe and following along, take a look at academicphoenixplus.com under downloads, and you can download this model for free. We're going to be covering a variety of tools, including planar mapping, stitching, sewing, and so much more. So if you are new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out your creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in UV mapping this axe. All right, so here we have our axe ready to rock and roll. Let's take a look at what our current UVs look like. So up here at the top right, we have Workspace. We're going to go to General, and we're going to go to UV Editing. And if I select it, it's not looking so hot. Up here on the right, we have, in the top right, we have a checker map, which we can trigger so that we can see how our textures would fall on our object. So as you can see, anything stretched, anything that looks like rectangles are not going to look great. Now, axe head itself looks okay, but there are some pulling and everything's upside down. So there's definitely things that we can improve. All right, so let's get started. If you haven't seen my previous video on introduction to UVs, please watch that first before we get started, because this might be a little bit over your head. And I go thoroughly over what UVs are and what the tools are. The first thing we're going to do is get rid of this cube. Let me go to display, heads up display, and turn off the cube. I personally don't need it. If you need it, you're more than welcome to keep it. But I know my X, Y's, and Z's at this point in my 3D career. All right, so we'll start with this. As you can see over here, I'm going to turn off the checker just so we can take a look. Even though the checker looks okay on the 3D model, the reality is that it's not looking so hot in the UVs, and it will be very hard to paint on this. So we're going to go to UVs, and I think the best option will be to go to planar mapping and then go to the options. Now, make sure that you always reset your settings, just because sometimes we click buttons, and then make sure that keep image width height ratio is on, and then you need to choose which way you want the projection to be. Now, if you're not sure, I always take a look at my little manipulator down here at the bottom left, and you can see that Z is the direction of this object. So I'm going to click on Z. So we have Z axis, we have keep image width height on, and then let's go ahead and click on apply. And actually, you can apply and close, and it looks like we have everything good. Let me turn on the grid again. But we also have numbers that are backwards on this side. So it's overlapping UVs. Now, in some ways, you can keep it like this, because if you want the same texture to be on one side as the other, then this could potentially work. But if you put in, like, let's say writing, such as U and 1, it will come out backwards. So just be aware of that. I'm going to split it. So the fastest way to do that is by going into edges. I'm going to use my model. I'm going to double click on that edge. Again, turn this off so I can see what's going on. Shift right click, cut. Go to faces, double click, move it aside. So now we have two UV shells. And the next thing we want to do is actually sew these guys together, because it's the same object and we want to make sure that we have as little seams as possible. So I'm going to go to edges. I'm going to click once, shift double click at the bottom. Shift right click, you can stitch together, or if you want to go to the right, we have cut and sew, and there is a stitch together button right here. So you get the same results. Now you notice that something really kind of strange happened, and the reason it looks like it went back to normal. I'm going to undo, and the reason why is because there is a direction. So one of the UVs was actually facing the wrong way. So I need to flip this. So I'm going to double click on this, shift right click, flip, or of course you can go over here and flip, and it is under transform, flip, and then we're going to go to do it again. Double click on the edges, shift right click, stitch together. All right, it's looking better. Still a mess. Let's do one last thing. Double click, go to faces, double click, shift right click, and then we're going to unfold. And now we have an unfolded axe. So what's nice about this, and if I move this around, you can see that the words or the letters and the numbers are facing the correct direction. And that means that if I put some sort of text, it will show up correctly. Can always rotate this. The grid looks good. All right, let's move it aside. Let's move on to the next piece, this one. All right, so this is the cylinder. This is all stretched out. We are going to use cylindrical mapping. So let's go to UV cylindrical mapping. You can see what a wreck it is. And you can also see, and I'm going to turn off the grid just because it's easier. The seam is all over the place. So we're going to go ahead and close the projection. And there's a little T at the bottom. Click on that little T. And then you can actually rotate this. And I'm going to put the seam in the back of the axe. Now you'll notice that it's not great over here in the UVs, so I'm going to slightly rotate it to try to close that hole. But I know that because of the shape and the fact that it's thin and thick, I'm going to get some issues. But I am going to try to move the seam at least to the back as best as I can. There's going to be some cutting and sewing for sure. I think that's as good as I'm going to get for now. And then I can go from there. Another method is what we can do is the same thing we did with our axe. And now I know that this is flat and this is round, but we can do a similar method. So we can go to UVs, planar mapping. Then we're going to grab some edges. So double click, shift double click. Then the big one is up here at the top. I'm going to press the number one to make sure. You have to make sure that the whole thing is cut. Now, this is an N-gon, which is not good, but I'm going to go ahead and click all the way around because one of them has to be cut like a piece of paper. And let's look at the bottom. We need to do the same thing at the bottom. Take a look in here. This is distracting, so then I'm just going to do the same thing. I'm going to select these edges. And then cut, shift right click, cut. Double click on one side of the faces, double click, and theoretically it should split. Now it didn't, so that tells me that there is still a face or an edge that wasn't cut all the way. So it's like a piece of paper. If it's still attached somehow, the whole paper is still one piece of paper, not two. So select that edge, shift right click, cut. Let's go to faces, and then it would split. Awesome. Now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to double click, shift right click, flip. There it is. And now I have a seam. The seam, I want to put it in the back. So this edge here is the one I want to keep. So I'm going to grab the edges in the front. Get rid of these because I really don't want to have any of them here. Go all the way up. Same story here. I don't want any here at the top that will cause stretching. And then shift right click, stitch together. Looks beautiful. Nope, we need to fix it. Let's go faces, shift right click, unfold, unfold. So you're going to see a pattern here. Hopefully you're going to see a pattern soon, as the more you UV map is that you're going to cut, you're going to sew together, you're going to unfold. And anytime you make adjustments, you unfold some more. Let's take a look at the grid, and the grid looks pretty good. All right, let me just kind of slightly rotate it so that it's more up and down, and then move it aside. And you can always unfold again if you feel like it needs a little bit more love, and then just make sure that it's rotated up and down. Awesome. It's coming along. Don't forget to save. All right, let's do this one. Same story. Doesn't look so hot. Looks like a cylinder. UVs. Cylindrical mapping. This one I might actually be able to just use. So let me just close this, click on the little red T and rotate it. There's not much shaping to it. It's literally just a cylinder. So this will probably be the best, easiest use of the cylindrical map. So that looks pretty good. I rotated it so the seam's in the back. Then I can go in and unfold, unfold. And just like that, easy peasy. Whoop, bringing this down. Okay. This one is very similar to this one. So let's go ahead and planar map. Let's grab those edges. Double click. Shift right click, cut. Let's go to faces, split. Double click, shift right click. Whoops, wrong way. Flip. And then it's up to you where you want to stitch. I'm going to stitch it right here along the edge. So here, again, sometimes it's easier to see it without the grid. Click here. And all the way down. Shift right click, stitch together. Faces. Unfold, unfold. And there we go. Now there is one edge here that I might want to stitch again, and this edge here. So I might actually go in and stitch those together. You'll notice that it didn't work. That's because I actually need to sew. And so there we go. So I just want to make sure that edge, that seam is not there. The seam should be along the way, right? But there shouldn't be a seam here. Just because I made some adjustments, I like to unfold. And here we are. We now have all of our pieces UV mapped. Yay. All right. So the next part is laying it out, which means that we want to take all of this and put it in the 0-to-1 space. However, something that we need to be aware of is the texture or the grid. So the grid basically tells us the quality of the texture in this object. So in this side, you can see that this 3D object has big grids, and then some of them have really small grids. So that means that the texture will be very different on all sides. So I'm just going to demonstrate to you what that means, because we're visual learners. We're going to right click, assign a new material. Let's go ahead and grab an Arnold. You don't have to use an Arnold AI shader, but I'm going to use a standard shader because I love it. Then I'm going to actually delete all my history, because center the pivot, delete the history, and freeze the transformations, because I'm trying to get to my tabs here. Let me go to color. Let me go to file, click on that little folder. So I'm going to be using this cobblestone. Doesn't make sense to the object, but you know, just bear with me. So I'm going to press that, press the number 6, and boy, it's dark. Let me see if I can lighten it by changing this into raw. Okay, there we go. So you'll notice that even though this object is supposed to be sharing the same texture, which is our whole goal, you'll see that in the body of the axe, the stones are really large, but in some other areas are really small, and the quality of the texture looks better in the smaller ones than it does on the big ones. It starts to break down. So the goal for us is to actually UV map places in the 0-to-1 space with the exact same grid. So I'm going to go back to my UV editing tools, and there is a great tool called Texel Density, which you guys can find under Transform. So open up Transform, scroll down until you see Texel Density, and I'm going to leave my map size at 512. That's fine. Let's go ahead and click on Get, and then we're going to click on Set. And then right off the bat, you can see that it changed all the UVs into the size of equal texture size. So you can see that the grid is all the same. Let me turn off the checker. And you can see also that the grid or the texture that I just assigned looks the same size. And that's exactly what we want. So I'm going to select this. I'm going to go ahead and assign just a regular standard surface. So it's nice and boring. And now we have our UVs in the same texel density. With that being said, let's go ahead and put it into the 0-1 space. Down here at the bottom, you're going to see arrange and layout. Open that up, and then you're going to see something called layout. Go ahead and click on layout, and they will keep the texel density and also put it in the 0-to-1 space. Awesome. So here comes the fun part. You will notice that we now have everything in the 0-to-1 space. All the texel density is correct and looking good, but can we make it better? So what I mean by that is there ways that we can actually fill in the 0-to-1 space? Because there's a lot of empty space here. Now, if I had other objects that were going to be in the scene, I could add the UVs here if I wanted to. But in this case, I really want to make sure that this axe has as much 0-to-1 space as possible, because it's texture. I'm able to put more texture information into these things. So there's a couple of things I could do. One is I can might potentially cut the edges here and separate the handle. If I can get close enough here. Oh boy. There we go. Double click. And I can separate, this is going to be wood, this is going to be leather, and down here is going to be wood as well. I can go ahead and cut, and then I can move this, right? So that means I can make this even bigger still. Other things I can do is actually, since I want this to have the most detail, because most people are going to be paying attention to that, I can actually increase the size of this object. Not too much, but I can, right? But since I made some changes, let's go ahead and select our objects. I'm going to click on the texel density again. So get, set, and then I'm going to go to layout. So now you can see that it did a better job laying it out and taking up more of the 0-to-1 space. And the grid is still really nice. Can I make this a little better? Well, I can try. I can always move some of these things around. So I can kind of move this here, maybe move this down here. And since I do want to scale this up a tiny bit more, maybe I can squeeze this a little bit more this way, squeeze you a little bit more that way. And then maybe I can expand this a little bit more. And there you go. You now have a UV mapped axe ready for texturing. Don't forget to save. And the next step would be to go ahead and take this into Substance Painter or a 2D software like Photoshop and start creating your textures. So hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe, because that is your message to me, letting me know that you like this type of content and that you want to see more. If you want to see more UV mapping tutorials, leave a comment below. I do read your comments. I may not have time to respond to all of them, but I do read them. So please leave a comment. We love that. And of course, share my videos. If you feel like my videos are helpful and can help another artist just like you, then please share my videos. That would also be really wonderful and helpful for my channel. And don't forget, you can download this axe at academicphoenixplus.com and do this tutorial as well. So follow along. That would be cool. And don't forget to tag me in your social media, because I am a huge fan of artists that show me what they've done with my tutorials. It's really, really cool. So I would appreciate it if you guys would tag me in your social media. So again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time.